Hello everyone, in this video we are going to understand about the decision theory. Decision making is the integral part of any organization. Decision makers select the best alternative from the available alternative. This decision theory is broadly divided into the three topics: decision under certain condition, that is decision under certainty, decision under risk, and decision under uncertain condition, means decision under uncertainty. In the first condition, decision under certain condition or the decision under certainty, according to this condition, the perfect information is available in the perfect environment. Decision under risk, according to this condition, incomplete information is available and that information is available in form of probability distribution. In decision under uncertain condition or decision under uncertainty, partial information is available. Now in this video we are going to solve the numerical problem of decision under uncertain condition or decision under uncertainty. There are five types of the decision under uncertain condition. First type is the Laplace criterion. We call it equal probability criterion or equally likely decision. Second type is criterion of optimism. In that we are going to find out the alternatives or strategies with the help of the maximax criterion and minimax criterion. Third type is the criterion of pessimism. In that we are going to find out the alternatives with the help of the maximin criterion and minimax criterion. Fourth type is the minimax regret criterion. In that we are going to solve the numerical problem of maximization problem and the minimization problem. And the last type is the Hurwitz criterion. Again, in Hurwitz criterion there are two problems: maximization problem and the minimization problem. Now look at the first problem, Laplace criterion, equally probability or equally likely decision. In this problem, we are going to select the best alternative with the help of the Laplace criterion. For that purpose, we are going to calculate the expected value of each alternative with the help of this formula, 1 by n into p1 plus p2 plus p3 up to the pn. Here, n is equal to event and p is nothing but the payoff value of strategies. Now look at the problem. The following matrix gives the payoff of different strategies, that is alternatives S1, S2, S3 and S4 against the condition events N1, N2, N3 and N4. Now here there are four alternatives S1, S2, S3 and S4 and there are four events N1, N2, N3 and N4. 1000, 1500, 750 and 0. Four are the payoff value of alternative 1. S2 is 250, 2000, 3000, 750 and 3000 are the payoff value of alternative 2, that is strategy 2, minus 500, 1250, 3000, 4000, 750. These are the payoff value of alternative 3, minus 1250, 500, 2250 and 4000 are the payoff value of alternative 4. Here we want to find out the best strategy according to the Laplace criterion. Now for that purpose we are going to find out the expected value for each strategy, for S1, S2, S3 and S4. As we are aware that, now here first step is to find out the expected value. Now formula of the expected value is equal to 1 by n into p1 plus p2 plus p3 plus p4. Now we want to find out this expected value for each strategies. Now expected value of S1 is equal to 1 by n. Here n is nothing but the event N1, N2, N3 and N4. There are 4 events. Therefore 1 by 4 into. Now this expected value is for strategy 1 and payoff value of the strategy 1 is equal to 1000, 1500, 750 and 0. Therefore in bracket 1000 plus 1500 plus 750 plus 0. Now this expected value of strategy 1 S1 is equal to 812.50. Now we will calculate the expected value for strategy 2. Now here again we will use the same formula. S2 is equal to 1 by 4, 4 is the number of event, into. Now the payoff value for strategy 2 is 250, 2000, 3750 and 3000. Therefore 1 by 4 into 250 plus 2000 plus 3750 plus 3000. Therefore the expected value of S2 is equal to 2250. Now we will calculate the expected value for alternative 3, that is strategy 3, is equal to 1 by 4, again 4 is number of event, into the payoff value of alternative 3, that is minus 500 plus 1250 plus 3000 plus 4750. Therefore, the expected value of S3 is equal to 2125. Now, expected value of strategy 4, that is alternative 4, is equal to 1 by 4 into minus 1250 plus 500 plus 2250 and plus 4000. Therefore, expected value of strategy 4 is equal to 1375. Now here we have calculated the expected value for the alternative 1, alternative 2, alternative 3 and alternative 4. Expected value of S1 is equal to 812.50, S2 is equal to 2250, S3 is equal to 2125 and S4 is equal to 1375. Now we will write down this expected value. After this calculation, again I would like to summarize. Here we have calculated the expected value for each strategy. S1 expected value is 812.50, S2 expected value is 2250, S3 expected value of S3 is 2125 and expected value of S4 is equal to 1375. Now here we want to select the strategy according to the Laplace principle. Suppose if this is the payoff matrix, then here we want to select the maximum expected value. In the above expected value, the maximum expected value is this 2250. Therefore, according to the Laplace criterion, strategy S2 is selected. Now this is for the payoff matrix. S2 is selected. Here I would like to mention one very important point. Suppose if you are finding Laplace criterion for payoff matrix, then you have to select the maximum expected value. According to that, strategy S2 is selected. But suppose if this is the cost matrix, and in the cost matrix, suppose if we want to select the strategy according to the Laplace criterion, then here we want to select the minimum expected value. Now according to available value, the minimum expected value is 812.50. Therefore, according to the cost matrix, we will select the strategy S1. For payoff matrix, we have selected the maximum expected value, and according to that, S2 strategy is selected. And suppose if this is the cost matrix, then according to that, we will select the minimum expected value 812.50, and according to that, strategy S1 is selected.